Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Proverbs with Paul in the afternoon. Proverbs chapter 10 and verse 3. The Lord will not allow the righteous to hunger, but he will reject the craving of the wicked. So the Lord will not allow. This idea that the Lord allows and not allow is a really important lesson to learn. Not every victory is ours instantly. It needs to be fought for. It needs to be won. And this concept of God allowing, or rather seeing his will be done in a life situation, is all about God allowing and not allowing. So the idea of him allowing us to go through a particular experience isn't because God wants us to go through it, but he will allow us to go through it because there may well be lessons to learn while we're in it. It's not that he wants it, but we will learn lessons through it. But on the other hand, God will not sometimes allow things to happen as well. So this idea of allowing and not allowing is in the provenance of God. God's will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And there's a scripture that says that all things work together for good for those who love the Lord. So even if we do go through a difficult situation, there will be good coming through it. But it's still not that God wanted us to go through that situation. It's just that life is filled with battles won and lost. And we are sometimes victims of the circumstances around us. And so we will bear the same sufferings and pains as everyone else does. And so God's allowing and not allowing is really important. And so the Lord will not allow the righteous to hunger. And the reason why he won't let the righteous hunger is because if the righteous live right, by the very right that they're living, will provide for them in their hour of need. No matter what's going on, the righteous will have had made provision from them for themselves, because they would have been acting in the right way on the journey before the poverty or the famine came upon them. So the righteous have made ample provision. They've been prudent in the journey towards starvation by making plans to accommodate themselves in that time of need. And the best place you can see that is when God took the initiative, when he provided Joseph to protect Israel when Egypt went through that famine for that long period of time. And it was in fact that made Egypt as wealthy as it became. So God makes provision for us because the righteous are listening to him. Unfortunately, that is not the same for those who have cravings for the wicked, but he will reject the cravings of the wicked. And like the righteous have made provision, the wicked, they never make provision. They leave it to the last minute. They in effect turn up one day and say their cup is empty. There's no more seed in the barn. Nothing to sow, therefore nothing to reap. And so the wicked are often foolish and they're not acted prudently. They've not prepared for the possibility of the inappropriate. And so there's some challenges there for us today with regards to those who are mindful of what's coming and being aware of that and making provision for that so that when it comes, we're amply supplied. Thank you for listening today. Be blessed. Have a great afternoon and I'll see you tomorrow.